The gentleman said to mention the champagne goes well with truffles when you're ordering.
Well, why don't you take the champagne, take it back to the gentleman?
No. Please just take the champagne and say thank you.
I'm confused. What do you want me to say?
It's okay. Well, I'll deliver the message myself.
Ian.
Kevin. Hi.
Hi.
I'm sorry. I don't know how you got out of jail or who helped you. You got to stay away from us.
You don't like the champagne?
You know that I have a restraining order against you.
You're absolutely right, Lucy, and I was the appropriate number of feet away until you two walked over here.
The point of all this is it's just not going to work. Doc, you're not going to intimidate us, really.
I'm just trying to bury the hatchet, Lucy.
If you ever touch her again, I will kill you.
You know what? I suddenly feel like dining at home, shall we?
Yeah.
Sorry, I ruined your evening.
Hey, you're Stephen Clay.
Just make my drink.
Sure thing. What do you want?
Bourbon.
Yeah, come right up.
Bad day.
I've had better.
Valentine's Day. Must be hell for those of your ilk.
Yeah, well, I don't see you surrounded by a whole lot of love. I guess a restraining order will do to you.
Yeah, touche. So then, what do two lonely guys talk about?
Tonight, nothing.
Actually, I have a subject we haven't touched on in a while. My daughter, Livy. Come on, you promised to bring her back, but so far all I see is Tess. What's the matter, Caleb? Losing your touch?
I'm home.
Jack.
Tess. What's going on?
No, what do you mean, what's going on? What does it look like? Won't you come dance with me for old time's sake?
Old time's sake?
Oh, come on, stop pretending you don't remember. You miss me, babe?
So Ian's a vampire, and Lucy's a slayer. But according to this little notation, their lovemaking made Ian better. This could mean that there's a cure.
You should let me deal with him.
Yeah, right. Then he wins, and you get in a lot of trouble. No, I shouldn't have.
You know what I said. If he hurts you again, I'm gonna kill him.
I know. I don't believe that's what he wants to do right now. I think part of his plan is just messing up my life.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too. I'm sorry you have to be involved in any of this.
I know. If you tell me you're not stopping,
no.
You're not stopping.
Oh, Ian, I'm so glad you're home.
What are you doing here?
I've just been really worried about you. You haven't been by to pick up water in such a long time.
I have plenty of water left.
Oh, you're certainly stronger than I am. I haven't been drinking very much myself, and I'm ready to jump out of my skin. You haven't been feeding on anyone, have you?
No, don't be ridiculous. What are you talking about?
He is absolutely fine.
I'm sure you've heard that I've left Stephen.
What do you want here, Elizabeth, really?
It's just lonely. You know. Ian is one of the few people that can actually understand what I'm going through.
Oh, gosh. You know,
To me, the reason he could possibly understand that is because you're the one who turned him into a vampire.
Lucy, it's all right.
No, it's not all right. You know what? You should take responsibility for what you did. What, you come over here and ask after you put that curse on him how he's doing? I'll tell you how he's doing. He's been going through sheer hell. Does that answer your question?
What's the matter? Why are you so upset? What's going on?
It was just one of those days that we're feeling rather helpless, and I guess it was pointless to be worried about you because you look very good.
I have been helping him out. I've been taking care of him, okay?
You're taking care of him. A slayer. And a vampire.
Yes,
I'm fighting it in the same way you should be fighting it until we come up with something else.
Are you sure there isn't anything
else? I'm sure. I'll let you know if something comes up, okay?
Yeah, maybe there is something and you're just not telling me.
Would you leave him alone? He does not owe you anything. Well,
Ian, thank you. Listen, could you and I just go somewhere and talk?
Listen, no, I don't know.
Please, I really need a friend right now, and you've been so good to me under the circumstances, and it's just things are just getting really desperate.
That's enough.
Get away from him and keep your horny hands to yourself.
Stephen Clay?
Oh, my God, it is you.
Can we have your autograph?
And take our picture with you?
Would a kiss do instead?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Well, you do have a way with the ladies, I'll give you that.
They always love the bad boys. But you should know that by now.
Yeah, I guess some of them do.
Your daughter did.
But we're not here to argue Livy's strengths and weaknesses, are we? The fact that she chose to be with you breaks my heart, but there it is.
Giving up?
Me? Never. But I think you are.
What is that supposed to mean?
She's sweet, isn't she? Tess. Oh, yes. You think you'd have it all mapped out, all your ducks in a row. And then she hits you with those innocent brown eyes and you just get lost. I think Tess gets to you. I know she challenges you. I mean, she's not like those other girls who think the sun rises and sets on you. That makes you want to get to her even more, doesn't it?
What? You gonna shrink me now, Doc? Tell me what's wrong with me up here?
Psych 101. It's called obsession.
What's the matter, Jack? You do not look happy to see me.
How did you get here?
Isn't the better question, what are you gonna do about it?
Where's Tess?
Here, where I've been and where she'll stay. Caleb wants me, Jack. He's calling me, can you hear it? I'm coming for you, my darling. Jack?
Tess?
You're home?
Yeah, I'm home.
What happened? I think I was about to...
No, don't open it, don't open it. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to scare you.
Hey, what's wrong?
Nothing. How'd you get this?
Stephen gave it to me.
All right. That's what I thought.
He said it belonged to Livy. Is there something wrong with it?
Tess, Caleb uses music box to make Livy do bad things.
Yeah, and Stephen gave it to me because... He said that he doesn't need it anymore. He's not going to go after Livy, and I should know that.
Did he tell you that?
Jack, don't worry. It's not going to make me do any bad things. He opened it for me. I listened to it, and it didn't affect me at all.
All right. Tess, can I ask you a favor?
Of course you can.
Can I get rid of it?
Why?
Well, it just, you know, it kind of brings back bad memories, and I just really don't want it in the house.
Yeah, I'll give it
back to
Stephen.
I'll take care of it myself. Okay?
Okay. Is Jack? Is there something you're not telling me?
No. No, sweetie, it's just that, you know, it's the memories. That's all. I'll just feel better once it's gone.
Okay.
Okay?
Let's do this. It'll be fun.
Okay. Usually, the first telltale sign is denial.
Ooh, thrill me some more.
You once told me, not that long ago, that my ego was a distraction, that it was more important to me not to lose to you than to get what I really wanted.
I was right.
Thing is, you're doing the same thing.
So now who's projecting?
The challenge, the resistance. The fact that you're not able to manipulate Tess, that must be excruciating to someone like you. I mean, especially someone who's used to women falling all over themselves just to experience your magic. But not Tess. She resists. And boy, does that piss you off.
So let me get this straight. You're saying now that Tess is the one I'm obsessed with. That's your diagnosis.
You tell me.
You can't read me. You can't know what I'm gonna do or how I'm gonna do it. I don't operate like anyone you've ever known before.
Is that so?
I've experienced more passion in one moment in my life than you'll experience in the entire run of yours.
And pain, too?
Well, that's the beauty of it. In my world, there's an intensity and power without all the anxiety and helplessness and guilt that rules your world. Once you've had what I have, you can never settle for anything less.
But when you get down to it, none of that really matters, does it? Because whether it's Tess or it's Livy, you're obsessed with the love of a woman to the point of forgetting almost everything else.
Your psychobabble bores me, Doc.
Oh, now, come on, Caleb. The longer you live among us, the more like us you become. You're becoming human.
Excuse me, you want me to get my what?
No, let me correct you. I said keep your horny hands to yourself.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to upset anyone.
Well, you should go home. Come on, out. Hello?
You didn't leave yet. I just wanted to say a few words to you.
Why are you so threatened by me?
You can't really be serious.
You know what we are. You know that we have certain desires that can only be satisfied by our own kind. At least that's what I've always been led to believe.
Yeah, maybe. Well, you know what? I need to know. Did you really just think you were going to drop over and have, what, a little bite, maybe a little feeding, a little dinner, a little sex? Is that it?
You can't possibly satisfy him.
That is none of your business. But what's my business is taking care of him. And what you have done is so abhorrent and selfish. What were you thinking? Elizabeth, were you that lonely and that hungry to put this curse on such a wonderful, generous, incredible man and ask him to live like this? What were you thinking?
You have no idea what it's like.
Oh, and you have no idea what it's like for me to watch him, and now you're coming over here, what, to do more damage, to suck the life out of him? Is that it?
He wanted me. He was enjoying himself. You only interrupted.
That is enough. What I interrupted was I wanted to stop him from feeding so he wouldn't become like you, and obviously you've developed a taste for feeding, haven't you?
So it's true? It's true he doesn't feed. He doesn't drink the water. He relies only on
Yes, him. That's right.
So tell me how that's possible.
I would like to tell you many.
Everything okay out here?
Yeah. I was just wishing Elizabeth a swell evening.
I'm so sorry that I interrupted you. I can't tell you how happy I am to see that you're better.
Ta.
Horny hands.
Yeah, you know, oh, that was embarrassing. I don't think I've ever been quite so inarticulate. It was just stupid thing to say.
Hey. Try to be compassionate. She doesn't have anybody. I have you. I'm very grateful.
I know. You're right. You're absolutely right. I'm sorry I got so upset.
And boy, there's actually a way out of this. I can actually go back to being normal. All I have to do is sleep with a vampire slayer. Hi, Rafe. It's Elizabeth, your mother-in-law.
Okay, so tonight we had Kevin and Elizabeth. So I'd say that's just about ends the old Valentine's Day feeling, huh?
No, because I'm not here now, it's just you and me.
Yeah, you're right. Okay, so no more talk about stripping leprechauns or Kevin or Elizabeth.
You know, you don't only make me feel better, you make my whole life better. I didn't think I could feel this way again.
Me too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I still think I owe you.
Oh, yeah, you know, you owe me big time. But I think I owe you a lot. And maybe part of it's just putting up with me.
That's right, I do that, don't I?
Yeah. Wait, no, you're not supposed to agree with me. You're not going anywhere, are you?
No. I put up with all the craziness in the world if I could spend the rest of my life with you.
I don't see how things could get much crazier.
With vampire and a snare.
Yeah. But you know, that is not what we are to each other. Not really, not deep down inside here, right?
No.
No. But I am glad I'm a slayer. Because if being a slayer and making love to you makes you feel better or helps you, then I'm glad I can do it. You know, I've been thinking about that. Maybe it's not just my slayer-esque stuff. Maybe it's my sparkling personality.
Really?
Maybe I have some sort of calming effect on you.
Calming effect.
Yeah, yeah, or maybe it's just some sort of aura that I put out.
Aura, is it? Mm. No, I have my own theory.
You do really? What is it?
I think you make me feel this way because you allow me to love you. And there isn't a feeling in the world can hold a candle to that.
There's nothing wrong with being human, Caleb. I mean, there's more of us than there are of you.
Once again, you reach for the obvious.
You're such a good liar. You've convinced yourself that everything's still under your control. But they're not. And deep down inside, you know it. I'll send you my bill.
Late, Jack. You should come to bed.
Yeah, well, I'll be there in a minute.
You're hurting. I can feel it.
No.
It makes me hurt, too.
I'm fine now. Now that I have you in my arms.
Everything's gonna be okay.
You know that you're the most beautiful, wonderful person in the world. When I look at you, it's hard to believe there's something wrong.
I love you.
I love you too.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next Port Charles. Surrender.
Next, Port Charles.
Rafe's a slayer, and I'm just certain that he's the only one that has what I need.
So let's see. The music box, Jack.
Why?
Because you see, whoever controls that box controls the next time Livy makes an appearance.
The residents of Port Charles are about to have their lives turned upside down by the fans. Wednesday at 10 p.m. Eastern and Pacific, turn on SoapNet for an entertaining hour of General Hospital. SoapNet, every day a new twist.